Hello there, and welcome to another episode of X4 with the Star Wars Interworlds mod 0.80 installed. I'm in a Porax, which means we're doing our ICG, our Independence Commerce Guild playthrough today. Now, you are going to have to forgive me a little bit, because I started recording this episode earlier on today, which is Wednesday, and unfortunately during my recording we had a power cut, so I'm a little bit behind on the save. I don't 100% know where we're kind of at or what's going on. The things I do know, I've got 63 million, which sounds about where I were. We've got our builder building some stations. We've got a bunch of station defense building mission, which is why how I've managed to accrue this amount of money. And we should have enough for an allocator. Now, I was having to think what ships we want or what ships I would like. And the allocator should be around about 59 million. Yes, same price as it was. And the reason I'm going for the allocator, one, it's quite new. Two, it's got a very, very good average turret output. And three, it's got a decent complement of fighters. So we've in our fleet, we've got some tri-droids, which are fantastic. Well, they're okay. But they're not very fast. The jump speed's pretty damn slow. So having something that can carry them is going to be better for us, because it means we can look at getting vulture droids and the bomber variants and stuff like that. Have it very droid orientated instead of to rely on those meatbag units. And obviously we'll get some Vigos as well, because the Vigos are fantastic. So I'm going to add that to the shopping list and confirm that order. Leaves us with 4 million left, which is fine. We are at a point, or we were at a point, where we're going to start getting fleet supply demands soon, but that's fine. I'll just very quickly kind of go over what we've got kicking around on this. So it's allocator. We've got, I didn't actually check which engines are. We've only got one. So it's just, yeah, so allocator, Mark II thrusters, military grade, shields, you know. We've got the heavy turrets. I think, yeah, I put ions on this as well. So we've got a couple of banks of iron cannons, just so he's got a bit of variety of damage, so we can see about plinking off some shields and stuff like that. And then crew-wise, it's got 5 marines in it, rest is service crew, and then the usual kind of like, mostly repair drones, cargo drones, so we can trade with stations that might not have cargo drones and things like that. So that's the thing, that's something that's going on. Let me just check the messages. It's time for maintenance, yes. So we are at the hands of the maintenance feast now. So last couple of times, we were short by 58 maintenance ship supply. We have slightly upgraded this station down here. It's now got some storage on it, so I need to configure that, and I'm going to go over that. And we also need to claim rear, and I think that kind of brings me up to where I was. Well, we don't need to complain to get rear. We do need some more systems to basically, because each defense station gives us plus 100, I think, for each claim sector. And the way I've decided I'm doing it, just to make things relatively cheap, we're going to keep nice bare bones basic 2x2x2, which results in a 4x4x4 plot. I'm just going to stick it up here, continue. And you don't really need much to claim a sector. You just basically need a claim module. So, admin center, a couple of defensive discs, put it on high preset so it has got what it needs. Confirm that module, manage resources, accept that estimate at 2 million. We're not going to assign a builder now. I don't think there's any builders kicking about, to be honest. There is. We'll spare the 150,000. Why not? We'll get that kind of like built up. That ICG one might actually get destroyed because it's in if it goes through here. We'll see. So yeah, that's where we're at. I'm not worried about money as it stands at the moment, because soon as this station is built, that will give us... Is that the 20 up to 29 million one? Nope. It is that one set to active. Which is Oh no, it's what? What's going on? What's going on, 3PO? Where's my builder boy? Ryloth. Is that one to active? Is it that one? There's one in Ryloth. Or am I just building a station? I'm not building a station for the sake of it, am I? Is it that one? Yes, it's that one. So we're going to get up to 22 million for that. So we've got 22 million from that, up to 29 million from that, up to 17 million for that one. So money-wise, it is not going to be a problem. So I thought we'd kind of do this. So on the other playthrough that we're doing, which is kind of like a HAPES / CSA playthrough, this is how I've kind of done it. So I've already built this. This station basically makes ship supplies for us. This station in here is a defense station with a single storage compatibility thing. If you go into logical overview and then you go select a tradable ware, and we go ship supplies and confirm, basically what should happen, create a buy offer, it should start supplying us with the parts that we need. And hopefully it'll come from our own thingy. We could do with buying like a little trader for it, which we'll do. We'll buy a small old Shethapede if they sell one. There we go, Shethapede. High preset, it's only 700 and odd thousand. We do need to slightly configure this though. We don't want Marines, we want those guys. Save a bit of money, we'll put Mark 1 combat thrusters because they're the cheapest. Why not? That brings it down there. And we'll leave everything else as is. Add that to the shopping list and confirm. And then that can start working for this station, which will then hopefully start bringing us in with kind of like more and more. And I think the plan is I'm going to initially head down towards this way. Auto Plutonia will be a good system to have in our arsenal because it's got a bit of everything. Hyporia, also a good system to have as a next door neighbor because that has a lot of resources and stuff like that. So, with all that introductions done, we kind of now know what's happening and what's going on. I'm going to wait for you to get a little bit more money, and the plan will be, I'll do these. Right, one of the reasons I'm doing these really god-awful mine missions is because I have quite a couple of these we will not abide by lawless one things, which if these factions have dropped those mines, basically what happens is I get paid for these. We've also got a promotional invite, so we'll do that. So Horsel and Kessel, or whatever they're called, the third party ICG ship vending machine, which are okay. I found that the Horsel and Kessel are a little bit understocked. I tried buying a builder from them because I think the builder's fairly new. I think I did that off stream. Like, they didn't have the requisites to be able to build a builder, which it's not a hardship to build, and it was a very basic component. So, and they always seem to be really highly priced compared to everything. I'm hoping the reputation and stuff like that will change things. But we have got plus 11. I've not bought any licenses from these guys. That is all just from the computer trading with them, basically, which is pretty good. Because as we know, more money or more reputation equals discounts equals access to ships. And although it's not a station that I'm like going to buy lots of ships from, it is the one that sells the Geonosian frigate. And we definitely want some Geonosian frigates in our life. So we'll get that promotion. We'll see what they offer. We might be able to get a Geonosian frigate after this one. I don't think we will. If we do, we're probably going to be missing like some of the capital ship stuff. But is the Geonosian frigate classed as a capital ship? That depends. Right, so receive a rank.
We've been watching your work with great interest and wanted to reward.
Thanks, Kao.
Amongst our organization, of course, this rank comes with great benefits.
Oh, it does have benefits.
Tied to the rank, so
mainly you'll let me buy some warships from you, which is always a bonus.
Record,
and like I said,
sure,
discounts are always good.
Find these rewards fitting to the work you've done and make the most of them.
I will, don't you worry.
You also find that certain organizations under our jurisdiction now have interest in you joining their ranks.
Ooh.
Once again, I thank you for your efforts. We look forward to
fancy.
Good luck out there.
Good. Posh voice followed by good luck out there. Good luck, mate. You could do it. Right, let's have a look. Buy ships. Large ships. We can't buy it yet. What do we need? We need military ships access. But we've got access to a few other bits and bats. I would imagine usually they give you access to the small ships and then to the large ships. I planted some satellites as well so we can see what's going on in this here zone. Medium ships, what do you sell? So Action 5 Vigo transports, not really much that we'd be interested in. I mean, if we find we could do with some heavy support freighters, the YV666 is pretty good. The R-41s are not bad. What do they sell? No, it's pretty much of a muchness. So we don't really got much from that. But it's something in it. It's an achievement. The other thing, before I kind of like take a little bit of a break and speed things along, Milago, the Bounty Hunters Guild, is no longer there. And the VLS Brewery looks like it might be on its way out. And that's either pirates have killed the Bounty Hunters Guild or the Vong are living in this system. So we might go and check that out at some point soon. But other than that, we've got to build a building. We've got an allocator building. We're doing well. We've got things kind of like happening, which is... which is good. Let's just name this. It's not a defense platform. Claim station. Confirm. So we might add on to this later. I mean, Rhea is a pretty rubbish system. It's got 50% sunlight. It's not very good. The rest of the fleet's kind of like sitting down here. Have you got any... Oh yeah, we bought the little sheath of pea, didn't we? Rename that to SR Sup 01. So we know what you are. You are going to trade for Commander. There we go. So that'd be good. I've got a feeling we're probably going to have to take out these hook pirates at some point. Because the hook pirates, they will go after our trade ships when it's got supplies and stuff like that, which is a little bit annoying. So we might end up with mini war. We'll see how it goes. If it's not much, we'll be fine. If it turns out it's quite a pain in the neck, we'll deal with them accordingly. So, as I said, I'm going to have a little sort of like play, a little kind of like, well, not play. I'm mainly going to be sat waiting. You want 3,333. Get that kind of like kickstarted. Get ship supplies in. I mean, Smuggler's Run. We could technically turn this into another ship supply center just so we've got them in. I'd rather save the money to get a equipment dock because that gives you a boost to ship supplies as well. I think what we'll do actually while we're here, we'll talk to you. Show me your blueprint. Do you actually sell any module blueprints? You do sell fabrication bays. So maintenance bays are the things we're going to be wanting. So small and medium is 35 million. That's doable. Large is 64. XL is 66. So it's going to cost a bit. We can do it. We don't have access to the bare bones basics containers. Okay. I don't think you guys actually have anything that I want.
Good luck.
So that's fine. So, like I said, we're going to have a mosey on over to Hyporia, I think. Is where we'll probably pick it back up when we've got a bit more money and we can see about paying some or getting some more blueprints so we can start building some things like missile, because we use a lot of missiles. Missile components would be probably good, and that kind of thing would probably be rather useful, I reckon. So we can become a bit self-sufficient rather than building ships. I'm probably going to work on more maintenance depots and stuff like that, so we can keep our ships funded. Because I think. So at the minute we're just kind of scavenging. We're taking systems that aren't part of anything else, so they're basically free for alls. But when we start thinking about claiming CSA territory, I think we'll probably make some sort of beachhead here in Targon, because these aren't the worst places for resources and stuff like that. So we'll probably make some sort of defensive beachhead in Targon. And then I think we're going to see about trying to claim Lothal. Because Lothal, if we can take Lothal and we can move into Moncal. Take Moncal, that'll give us access to all the Moncal shipyards. And then it'll give us a good kind of like beachhead. There's not many ways in and out of Lothal as well, so it's easy. Easy to control. We also need to find the moor, which the moor is around there. Have I actually got a free scout at the minute? You, sir, once you have done whatever you are doing, I want you to scout out Kessel. We'll find the moor. The moor's got a research station. We'll take that research station. Bish, bash, bosh. Away we go. So, yeah. So that's the plan. There we are. I'll be back very shortly.
Move along.
Allocator.
Hello, and welcome back. So, we've still not completed many of the stations, but the allocator's built. Look. Like a little shark hiding in the reef. So, yeah, we've got our allocator. So we'll do our kind of like usual. We'll have a little look round our allocator. So outside, it's got a very predatory look to it. I do like the look of the allocator. It's probably one of my favourite looking of the ICG ships. So a lot of turrets down the side. A lot of big boy turrets down the side. To look pretty good. We've got the big hangar bay. We've got that amazing engine array, which I don't understand why nobody in the Star Wars universe seems to understand the idea of armor plating around the engines. You can't tell me it's a heat thing, because then why have they got this fin in front of your main thruster bank? Obviously, everyone likes to see an engine. An engine looks very cool, but come on, guys. Put some armor plating around it. Makes it less vulnerable. Anyway, you got a decent shield emitter on there, which is a little bit exposed, but there we go. Another couple of turrets. So it looks like a pretty good broadsider. On the old precursory look, we've got the bridge on the top, a few smaller turrets as well. The same will be down the side. It's got these. I like the antenna on it because it's not as aggressive looking as like the Recusiant. The Recusiant looks cool, but it does look like a Reaper capital ship. Reapers in, is it Reapers or Reavers? Can't remember. The bad guys from Firefly. But this looks like a sleek old ship. Got two bridges. The ICG ships always make me laugh of where, mind you, saying that, most Star Wars ships, where they put the bridges. I think there's only one space sci-fi series where I think the bridges have been kind of like, that makes sense. And that's Battlestar Galactica, because they kind of like hide it in the middle of the most armoured part of the ships. Other sci-fi series is, well, let's build a great warship. We'll stick the most vital part, its brain, on the outside. But hey, you probably got some sort of blast shield. Grievous did in his ship, anyway. So, we've got this really sleek-looking hangar bay with some lovely tri-droids. So, we'll...
Docking granted.
Particularly want to dock in that one. We'll have a look round. We'll park our Porax. It sounds like it could be a thing another thing, innit? What? Park your Porax. Is it the same as all the other bridges? It looks like so. It does have the each separate hangar bay is its own thing. We go underground. Underground, overground. It's the Wombledon way. So let's have a quick look at these tri-fighters, because I don't think we've seen one of these up close. There we go. Look at those eyes. Like the tri-fighter, the tri-droid, I think is probably one of the best looking fighters the ICG made. Like, it just looks mean, doesn't it? Looks mean, it looks quick, it looks sleek. It looks like it's... Looks like a war machine. Look at it. It's just waiting there, kind of like, give me command to kill. Which is what you want to see. So they're pretty cool looking. We've got a bunch of those. We need to add to the fighter complement. But I think what we're going to do is we're going to focus on some mega station building sort of stuff in this episode. No other areas, it would seem, just the bridge, and I would imagine the bridge is going to be a stock X4 one. Yeah, whereabouts are we in the tippy top, or are we on the bottom? Looks like we're on the bottom bridge, which is fine. Makes more sense. Wouldn't want to be in the observation bridge, to be fair. So I think what we're going to do, We'll just do our little precursory tests. So, she's got a decent speed. She seems fairly manoeuvrable for a ship of her mass. She's not great. A little bit more manoeuvrable than the Venator. And we've got less weaponry. Ooh. Oh, wow. There's a bunch of stuff down there, so I'm going to collect that. That'll be a
high tech factory asteroid,
because these lodestones and stuff like that, they are worth the money to collect. She fly like, she looks good. Obviously usual jump drive on extra large ships takes a good old dog's age. Lodestones and alien eggs and all that good stuff. So the reason I like collecting these is simply because It's worth a lot. Alien omelets and stuff like that, they're worth over 1 million credits. The lodestones, you can use them to build bombs and stuff like that. So that's happy days. Now, we've got a slight problem. Our poor little Sheath Speed keeps getting assaulted by the Hutt Pirates. And I think what we need to do, we need to bring the allocator to its kind of... we need to test it. We need to christen it. And we're going to destroy this Hutt station. And we're going to get rid of the Hutts in this area. There's some more Hutt stuff kicking around in here as well. So we're probably going to make some enemies, but I don't care. I'm fed up with the Hutts, especially of the pirate variety. So why not test the allocator out by giving it a little bit of a baptism of fire, as they say. So I'm going to do that. And it looks like it's going to take a little bit of a while to get round. So as that's going, I'm going to do a couple of other things kind of like off screen. And we'll come back and we'll test out our little fleet, see how it does. Okay, so we're back. We're pretty much lined up with this here pirate scrapyard. a couple of reasons why I want to attack this. The main one is because whatever you got Hutt pirates in your system, they're going to try and attack your stuff. Which is never good. The other thing is, so earlier on, while I wasn't recording, this thing got attacked by the ICG, and the storage is full of module prefabs and durasteel plates and stuff like that. We can use those to essentially build all our stations in this system, which is the plan. So I can't think of a better test than this. Now, we might lose some ships. We just need to kind of let our cruisers and stuff like that get into a bit more of a viable position. Ideally behind us. There you go. They're wheeling along. A little tadpole. There we go. Cool. So,
pirate scrapyard.
Yeah, there's not really much else to say. We will drop a quick save, just in case it all goes horribly wrong. I don't think it particularly has much in the way of firepower or anything like that. We can have a quick check before we attack, though. So one thing I like to do with stations, before if I have the opportunity anyway, before I fully engage in an attack, is I like to check out what the crack is, what's going on with them, and check out the defensive capabilities. And you can do that. You just go F3 is the easiest way. And you kind of just have a look around. And oh, it's got quite a few defensive platforms. We've got 2, 4, 6, 10, 11, 12 by the looks of it. You can sort of see them clustered around here. Whether or not these defensive platforms are actually... Can we zoom in? Active? Yeah, so we've got guns on there. That's fine. So we will probably order... I mean, how much has it got left? Because we did... Okay. So we're not going to... We're going to attack from the bottom, I think. Will be the best way, because that way we're reducing its firepower. Now, generally speaking, pirate weaponry is a bit lackluster. It doesn't hit the hardest. Got all those. That is a full building storage. We can use a fighter for that. In fact, let's see how it goes. Mark as hostile. I don't care for you anymore, Hutt Pirates. Probably going to get some fire as well. We've got the Ordnance Cruiser on attack with me. We've got the Overseer defending the Ordnance Cruiser, and the Vigos are in support of the Overseer as well. That gives us kind of like nice anti-fire support.
Ordnance Cruiser.
He's already taken a couple of hits, so we're going to have to deal with this relatively quickly. In fact, pause map. I want to give you a specific order, Mr. Ardent Cruiser. I would like you to attack turrets. We'll make sure that is the top, tippy top of the priority list. And we'll just kind of go in blasting. Slow down a bit. So go, there we go. Here's the shark opening up. Does look like it hammers hard. Pretty good. Where's the overseer? Yeah, the overseer's there. Just hanging back as it should be. Wow. This thing does the damage. This is not even bringing like full weapons to bear. Let's just angle ourselves so we can start giving it a broadside. We'll also basically start screening our little friend. Work, shouldn't it? There we go, look. So we'll provide a bit of screening for our ordnance cruiser, who doesn't really seem to be doing a massive amount. Unfortunately, sometimes when you give them specific orders, it does confuse them somewhat. How are you actually doing? Your shields are going down pretty drastically.
Ordnance cruiser.
Tell you what, you.
Ordnance cruise trading station.
Just. Sometimes the controls on this game just do not make sense. Like, I want you to go and fly and wait here. We'll clear those off. Get it out of dodge before it does itself some mischief. We still got the overseer and the two Vigos. It's just the ordnance is. As an expensive ship to replace, just as much as our little allocator here, but not as cool. So we've got the ions opening up. Look at that! Boom, boom, boom. I always find something quite sinister about space battles, because they're always quite slow, but on the same token, they're always pretty, like, there's a brutal destruction kind of like element to them. And they can't complain that they're being attacked by the powers that be, because we are the powers that be in this sector. This is our system. They will respect our authority. And they've brought it on themselves. They shouldn't have basically attacked our poor little Sheathipede. Imagine that, a war being fought because they decided to attack a Sheathipede. Do you know what? I think we're actually doing more damage forward facing than broadsiding. I mean, if we could wedge it between there, that'd be hilarious. That'd probably kill us. It would also get us plenty of damage. One of the other things that I find slightly annoying about X4 is you can't tell the turrets what to attack. At least I don't think we can. Just attack all that. I mean, we can tell it to attack. We can sort it out, see our capital ships first. It's got a lot of red weaponry, so I do think this is probably going to be a good against the capital ships. Not only first. So there we go. Everything else, just shoot at wherever the hell you see. Oh, is that direct the fire a bit more towards the turrets? It does look like it, doesn't it? So we're going to have to take a little bit of a pounding. We'll let the ordnance cruiser kind of like regen shields, and then we'll bring it into attack again once we've kind of like got rid of some of this firepower down the sides. Tri-fighters won't be launching because they are on intercept. Looks like the Overseer is moving out as well. It's fine. So what's actually firing turret-wise? Oh, pretty much everything. Oh yeah, so it works quite well as a little head-on brawler. Should we bring our little... We'll just tell it to attack this time. No funny business, no flying and waiting and stuff like that. Those can back up. Apparently the Fleet Command stuff has been revamped for this version of X4, which is, what, 7.1? I'm not seeing particularly much kind of like groundbreaking improvements. I think some of the fighters and bombers are a little bit better, but, you know. We should back up, get a bit more angle of fire. I mean, we're getting it down slowly but surely. It's not exactly groundbreaking. Yeah, we're not going to win this battle fast, are we? Looks cool. Sounds cool. We've got the thunking guns, you know, the ones that go a bit like that'll be the ions, won't they? Empire Strikes Back, that was it, the massive ion cannons in Empire Strikes Back. They were cool. Boom, boom. We're destroying bits at a time. You can already see it starting to reduce its firepower out. So just hold here. I think we should be fine. We're probably going to need to do some repair work. Yeah, shields are taking a little bit of a pounding. There's not much point in trying to fly around it because it's too slow to avoid fire. So we'll just basically have to take the hits. It is slowly but surely like picking off some of the turrets, which is good. Reduced fire from pretty much one side. It's down to what? It's about half fire. Looks like that one's going to be next. Oh no, that one. Good. Good, good, good. Take them all out. I didn't see that one. Sneaky little turret there.
Shields are down.
Oh dear. Ordnance cruisers come in as well, which is brilliant. Whee, big bada boom. Look at that. She's just going to hammer the crap out of it now. Slowly but surely. I mean, our hull is 91%. It's all right. Repair drones can sort that out. We're only next door to Hyporia as well. So my plan is, and my thinking is, instead of buying more ships, because we're fine for defensive, like we've got enough to defend ourselves now. We're probably going to actually go more into building the stations up. So our station here, we're going to get a maintenance bay plonked on it, which when we've done the defensive contracts, we should have more than enough money to do that. How are we doing? How are we doing? Right, that's another turret down. So yeah, it's nearly down anyway. Boom, boom, boom. Wow. That's amazing. Yeah, so we're going to do a bit of kind of like building up the station. I'm probably going to show a bit of it as well because it's not much we've shown in a while, and I know probably I think we've got some new subscribers, so thank you for those that have subscribed. We'll kind of like show everyone a little bit of the old base building rather than just like, because I think we've been, probably both series have been a little bit more on the combat side lately. At least for the last couple of episodes. We've got our big capital ships now, our big flagships. Oh, we're down to 78%. Shouldn't be much of a problem soon, though. all the turrets are now pretty much on the other side, so we should be able to get a little bit of time to the ordnance crews are taking a little bit of a pounding. Let me just make sure I have how have we got you set out? Ordnance cruiser. Load out. Would have helped if we armed the missile. I am an absolute swine for that. Like turning weapon slots and stuff like that off. Right, let's move a bit to the side. I think most of the turrets are now pretty much dead and done for. I'm surprised the fleet's managed to do so well. We've got all these module prefabs as well, which we'll probably not even have enough room in our inventories to collect all these. But that will give us kind of like a lot towards like the next station that we build. Module prefabs are pretty expensive. I think we can hold it there. Yeah, just drill down on those. We're getting good training for our service crew as well, which is kind of like a bit of a bonus of taking so much damage. How are you doing? You're doing all right. You could do with taking a little bit less damage. I mean, we can... Right. If we move forward a little bit, I am going to order you guys to start collecting all the drops. Collect drops. Collect drops. Where is the other guy? Collect drops. We'll start kind of like... Oh! Alright, so we've got some close range
danger
cannage as well, which is good. So maybe this would be a better up close and personal brawler. Because, I mean, look at how much more firepower we've got going. But how much... down to 34%. How are you doing? You need to get out of dodge. Go there. Fly and wait there. Make that your top order. Please get out there. Get out of the way. We need to try and take out the turrets. See the turret base from here? Yes. So you can use the numpad to look around the cockpit, which is really, really useful. For stuff like this. Because one of the things they've changed in the latest version of X4 is the the camera on the third person one. Apparently it's an improvement. I personally hate it because it does this weird floating danger thing, which I'm not a fan of. I do not care for it. One iota. All right, let's start rolling a bit. I mean, we can take these turrets pretty quick. We're also screening our overseer as well, which is good. That is going to have to go to a dry dock to get some repairs. That's fine, as long as we'll all have to go. It'll be like a school trip. We'll all go to The dry dock. Oh, they're rebuilding.
Pirate scrapyard.
How? How are you rebuilding? How are you managing to do that? Oh, no, he's gone again. I did manage to get a builder next to it. Right, you must be running out of things now. Must be. What have we got? We got two docks. Two docks, and then that's about it. So is the... Because we've got those forward cannons as well. Are they kind of like more or less forward-facing firearms? Is that what you're trying to tell me? Well, that's that dealt with. Oh. I was wondering, why is the ship not rolling? Are the thrusters that bad? No, I was pressing R and not E. There we go, look at that. So last bits to take out. We got the docks, and then this station will be a hunk of slag, basically. You got a little scavenger. Oh no! Oh, the ordnance didn't get away. Oh, that's tragic. I'm not going to reload it for that. We'll buy another one. I didn't even like the ordnance, to be honest. Well, I did. It's a cool looking ship. I don't know how good it is. It's a little bit of a shame, though. If for no other reason, that's cargo space there. Now we've kind of lost. There we go. How much we cared. We've lost cargo space. Was the crew any? We could do with probably getting the crew though. So we'll launch a. You guys, can you? We can't dock. We'll do it individually. Right, so we need to get some crew. We need to get a ship, basically empty crew. I don't want to spend a massive amount. How about buying another Vigo but have no crew in it? Just pause it a second. Because I think that's how it can work. So medium, Vigo, pirate, but then I don't want any crew whatsoever. Add that to your shopping list. Confirm that order or I'm waiting on engine parts. Yeah, because basically I know when I've had less crew in, the crews of other ship have kind of like gone. Come to join me on the ship. So I think that's kind of how it works. I think maybe the Ordnance Cruiser is a better ship to have multiple of, maybe a couple of them. Maybe get them to hang back instead of using them how we're using them, which is like frontline fighter. Maybe. I don't know. Who knows? We need to try and get in a better position to destroy this dock. It's nestled in there real nice, like a tick. There we go, bring more guns. Guns to bear. Did I just shoot one of my own drones? Is that what's just happened there? There we go. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Right, how are we looking at with the old collection? You are full, so we'll start kind of like sending. In fact, you can get in on this action as well. Go on, collect those drops. Transfer wares. In fact, we'll get them to transfer wares with this place because it should have. Oh no, we can use the build storage. There we go. Build storage. All those energy cells. Good, good, good. And then when you've done that, collect more drops. You, same. Because I believe build storage is almost infinite. Maybe? I don't know. High drops. You. I mean, it's getting a lot of energy cells. I would much rather it go for the module prefabs, but what do I know? I'll just work here. And then collect drops. I mean, maybe it's just energy cells that are left. Oh no, there's a couple of module prefabs. I mean, at the end of the day, it's free energy cells that we can. Kind of like put into other stations and stuff like that, which is always nice. Is our Vigo ready yet? It's not even close. Just waiting on those engine parts. Come on, cancel that. And what about? We're probably going to need more trade ships anyway. So medium, just a bogo standard Vigo. On a high preset, but with no crew. Confirm. That shouldn't take too long. 6 minutes. You just got to survive 6 minutes, guys, and then at least some of you will live. There we go. Look at that. This is down to 5%. This is taking a real, real long time. Oh, there you go, look. Oh yeah, so this is definitely a forward facing ship, I reckon. That's how I'm gonna probably use it. Forward face it. Head on. Alright, cool. Yeah, I mean there's not really much more to say, is there, other than this station's nearly kaput. Damaged, doomed, destroyed. And all those good things. Where is our Vigo ready? No, it's not been 6 minutes yet, has it? 4 minutes. Guys, just live. Just live. Don't die. Oh, you're getting so much good stuff. Transfer words, build storage. Confirm. Collect drops. In fact, can we specifically have things like module prefabs? I think if we go on object list, usually show. Nope. Okay. But those. Collect that. Collect that drop. That's what we want. There we go. Right, hook pirates are done. They are done for. So I can put it in setter, which will just speed things along. We'll rescue these guys. And then we should be, I mean, we should have these defense platforms are building and stuff like that. So we're going to have plenty of money. And then what I'm going to do, like I said, I'm going to basically populate these with some buildings and stuff like that. Now, is there an order for, like, collect crew? Oh, you could rescue. Right. Rescue the crew! Go, 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 go! Rescue them all!
Space suit.
This is the bit of the film where basically this person and whoever else is nearby, they're kind of looking at the wreck like, oh my god! And then, you know, they're kind of talking to each other. And they declare their love for each other. I think pretty much every single modernish sci-fi series has had that scene in it. You know, they were jerks to each other before. Well, actually, it's because they love each other. They just wanted to live. Did Battlestar Galactica have something like that? I think Battlestar Galactica did have something like that. Look, no more Hut Pirate Scrap Station. Which should be good. You're taking forever. Well, we got some stuff. That's the main thing. We're full of... Oh, we got some module prefabs as well. Okay, have I got capacity for some other stuff? I don't want to watch you. Just basically waiting for this rescue to happen now, and then we'll probably call it an episode. We've done some destruction. I need to build some stations and populate everything. There is, so question time. There is a mod that I've seen, which I need to test it, but it basically reduces module build time to 1 minute. Which, I'm kind of like half and half. Usually when I'm playing games for myself, so like if I'm playing a Total War game or something like that, if it's like a campaign I've done loads of time and I just want to kind of like get to the good stuff and stuff like that, I'll turn like one turn buildings on and all that kind of good stuff. But obviously he's technically cheating, so I'd like to know like what people kind of like think to like a one turn build, or maybe some mods on that kind of like basis, and we'll sort of like see what's going on. Come on guys, you can do it. Rescue people in range, that's what. Rescue those people, and then when you've done that, just collect drops. What have you got? Can you transfer some wares for me? Yes. Oh, we can transfer wares. You've just been awkward before. That's fine. I get it. And then collect drops. And then you actually not fly and wait. Actually doing anything? You transfer wares with build storage. Get them all done. Get them all out. Fill that build storage and collect drops. Right, let's watch this rescue. I've never seen a rescue before. This is something new to X4, which is why I wanted to share it with the populace, so to speak. There's a whole rescue rangers thing. Oh, is that all my guys? It is. He's doing a right good job at this rescue malarkey. Nat. Are they all getting on board? Well, guys, you're going to be fine. Which means nobody's actually in the spacesuit. It's just the spacesuit. Oh, look at that. Oh wow, that's actually pretty cool. Oh, look, that's amazing. It's not amazing, is it? It's a thing, though. It's definitely a thing. Look, he's going to go around and he's going to collect, rescue all these people, which is going to add some crew members, which is fantastic. We'll get some service crew in that. And then we can get that little buddy working for us. Lovely. And everything has now evaporated, which is fine. Transfer words, we'll build storage. So we've actually got quite a lot of stuff, which is good. And if you think I'm going to be the one that navigates this beast into transferring the wares with our supply station, another thing coming. So transfer wares with build storage. Do that and do that and do that. There we go. Confirm. Lovely. Right, so on that amazing success story of us rescuing people, or us potentially rescuing people, he's taking a while, isn't he? We're gonna leave it at that. So as ever, thank you for watching. I have been Captain Jack Function. This has been Star Wars. No, it's not. It's been X4 with the Star Wars Interworlds mod 0.83 installed. And I'll see you next time.